Hello and welcome to Fieldwire. In this video, we will cover how to use Fieldwire for your punch list process. For reference, a punch list is the same thing as a deficiency, defect, or snag list. It's a list of items that must be addressed before construction is complete. Using Fieldwire for punch lists adds both speed and structure to your closeout process. You are able to run a better walkthrough and assign work directly to the people responsible for getting things done. Nothing will slip through the cracks and your project will finish stronger than ever before. There are many different ways to use Fieldwire tasks to capture your punch list. Among others, you can capture items on the fly or do a more formalized planned walk of each room or area in your project. Today, we'll run through one of the most commonly used ways, documenting items on the fly while you're walking or on site. You can create punch items on any device, desktop, iPhone, iPad, and Android, and if you're using a mobile device, you can even create tasks when offline, and they will sync when you have an internet connection again. Before we get started, we suggest that you configure your task categories and statuses first. You can customize these to capture your workflow and easily filter all of your tasks. Please see our help article linked in the description box for more detailed information. We will begin on the mobile version of Fieldwire in a model project that we've created. While on-site, you notice a drywall repair issue and you want to document it immediately before you forget. First, open your trusty Fieldwire app on your mobile device. Navigate to the relevant plan sheet and pinch out to zoom in on the problem area. Pull up your markup toolbar by selecting the triangle icon in the bottom right corner. Then, select the top icon in the toolbar, the task markup tool, which resembles a reverse teardrop, and tap your finger on the desired area to pin it to that area. A new task window will open. Tap on the Enter title line and add a title by typing it in or using voice to text. We'll call the punch task Drywall Patching and assign it to the drywall category. From there, press on the back arrow symbol to access the main body of the task. I'll select the camera icon and snap a quick picture of the issue in question. You can also record a quick video. After I've snapped a picture, I can even mark it up to add context and bring attention to the specific item. Now, let's communicate and assign this to the proper party. Rather than selecting Edit to view and edit all of my task's attributes, I can simply use the @ symbol as a shortcut to update or reassign the task status, category, and assignee. Select the message bubble icon in the far left corner and tap the @ symbol to assign this to the applicable status of your choosing. On that note, remember, among other things, that you can customize your task statuses and categories. Tap the @ symbol again to assign this item to the desired party. I can type or just use voice to text, which is especially helpful during your punch walks to quickly add notes as you go or to add a more detailed description. Patch ASAP. I'm also going to add a tag, so I'll be able to differentiate between general drywall tasks and punch items. Alternatively, you can also use tags if you wish to be able to group your different punch items by a certain punch walk date or other common denominator. Finally, I can post it. In my case, the assignee, Max, will receive a push notification so he instantly has all the information he needs. When he responds to the task, I will be notified with any updates. Now I'm going to add a checklist to my task. Checklists add structure to your workflows and ensure your team doesn't miss important steps to complete a specific task. You can add individual check items by selecting the checkbox and typing in details. You can also streamline the process by adding existing checklist templates. These are checklist templates that I've pre-created on the web version of Fieldwire. I can select one and have it loaded to my task and have my team check items as they go along. I can rinse and repeat and apply existing checklist templates to relevant tasks. If I click on the plus sign, I have the option to add attachments, forms, a scribble, or a cropped plan. Let's add a quick magnified image of the affected area on the plan sheet. You can click Edit in the top right and you can see all of your updated task attributes. Let's add a specific location for my punch item based on the location hierarchy I've pre-created. And finally, let's add a start and end date to specify when our punch task must be completed. You can make tasks as simple or as detailed as you want. The choice is yours. On punch walks, for instance, the pace can be quite rapid. In instances such as those, don't worry, you do not have to use all the different task options. You can capture the main essence of a punch item in a few seconds and move on to the next. Speaking of shortcuts, as I continue walking the site, I may encounter more similar drywall issues in other areas. To flag these in a flash, all I have to do is long press on the original task, and I can duplicate it and pin the duplicated task to the concerned area. Even if I'm offline, I can document punch items, and next time I connect to the internet, everything will sync back with my team. Last but not least, I can also email out this task with all of its content to anyone, even if they aren't on Fieldwire. Let's go back into the task and select the export icon. This is a box with an upwards arrow. From here, I have different options. I can share a link, generate a PDF, email out the task, and even generate a QR code. Let's jump into the web version of Fieldwire. Here in the Tasks tab, you'll be able to view all of the tasks on your project. It's a very interactive view, so I can filter them by categories and a variety of other attributes and drag and drop between my different statuses. Now I want to show you how to generate a punch list report based off the tasks you just created during your site visit or punch walk. You can set up report templates or create a new one by clicking on Generate Reports. We have three different types of reports. A detailed report is the most common report because it can be configured to include photos and all the other task details that you wish. You'll notice that there are sorting and filtering options so that you can customize the content of the reports. In this example, I have filtered for only open task items under the drywall category and with the tag #punch. I can input any recipients, regardless of if they use Fieldwire, and I can either send a one-off report or schedule a recurring report. Weekly reports are very useful to make sure that your project team knows what is assigned to them and what they need to accomplish. It's also a great way of keeping your subcontractors or clients aware of all of their open tasks in a formalized manner. For this report, I've set it up to go out every Monday morning, and it will contain all of the open drywall punch tasks. I no longer have to send multiple emails or call my drywall sub because they already have all of the information they need to finish their work and close out the project. Here is an example of what a detailed report looks like, complete with my company logo, which I added in my project settings. It will include all the selected task content, crop plans, checklists, photos, and it will be timestamped down to the minute. If you've opted to include full-size plan sheets, those will be included at the tail end of my report along with the filtered task pins. Once you've created a report template within the web version of Fieldwire, you will be able to send that pre-configured report from your mobile devices. Navigate to the Tasks module. Select the export icon. On Android, this will be the printer icon at the top right of the screen. This will reveal your web pre-created report templates. Choose the desired report and add recipients. Press Send and you'll see the report sent notification. Outside of scheduled punch walks, tracking punch items as they crop up from the get-go is a great way to get ahead. This saves you time and money by shortening the closeout process, which in turn makes you and your team look like heroes, equates to faster payment, and lets you move on to other projects. Ultimately, there are many different ways of leveraging tasks to manage your punch list efficiently. You can make the process entirely your own. That's a summary of how to use Fieldwire for your punch list process. If you have any questions, please contact us at support@fieldwire.com.